Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to Hard Knocks Tarot. I am very excited to see that I just gained a couple more subscribers. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you for subscribing and supporting my channel. Supporting this channel does support autism awareness, so just so you know. Autism family here. Loving life and staying grateful. I hope you all are too. Let's get some smoke in here. The dense energy. Energy in the air. I feel like the definition of Christmas is changing. I feel like as people are awakening to a more to being more involved in their spirituality, to becoming more of a team player in their life and in their spiritual journey, to be not just an onlooker but to be a participant, I think people are changing what it means when they celebrate Christmas. I think a lot of people are opening up to new ideas as to who Jesus Christ is. And I know this is a very touchy subject, but if you don't like what I'm saying, you have the free will to not watch this channel. You could also maybe start your own channel. That would be good too. I would definitely subscribe to it. I'm very curious as to how the collective is taking in all this new information. I could see that a lot of people are simply ignoring it. It's just too much. They're not spiritual to begin with, so you know, why would they pick up on anything, any new information about it now? Some people are finding it easier to connect with a spiritual side to them because of this new way of looking at who Jesus Christ is, and what the Bible represents, and how it has been manipulated, and why. That being said, I'm just going to leave it there. Okay, I don't want to go any further, but my point was this, is that it feels different. Christmas feels different this year. It feels different now. It's been feeling different. I think like the last few years, it's just been feeling an emptiness. And I think because we have been getting, we've been going through this transition, but it just seemed more obvious like the last few years. But this year I'm feeling like there's a little bit more optimism in the air, because there's a new way of looking at spirituality. And you know, it's nothing new. I know it's not new, but it is pretty new to a lot of people. So that's good. That's good. It's a good thing. It's something to celebrate. It's something to be happy about, that a lot more people are opening up to the idea that they are purposeful, they're important, their lives matter, and that they play a major role in the universe and what's going to happen, what's happening. So, you know, we all need to know that. We all need to feel that. We all want that. We all need that. And it's, we all are born with that desire for a purpose, because we were made to follow through with a mission. Our lives were purposeful, and at first it was for a very shallow reason, for some very low vibrational beings, but we're raising up our value and our purpose. And again, I'm gonna stop there. Okay, this is a positive message, and don't want to get too deep into it just yet, but it's a good thing. Merry Christmas, happy holidays. I can't wait for the new year. Let's get this party started. Let's see what I got here, guys. Let's see. I have the Hidden Truth Oracle. Yeah, I'm going to go back to my basics. I got the little mini tarot deck. I got my badass book. Okay. All right, so let's do the Light Seers. It's popular. The diagrams are fun and easy to understand. All right, guys. spirit guides and angels, galactic council, ancestors, source, God, the Almighty, the Most High, thank you for the cards and the words for today's reading to relay the message that is intended for the greatest good of my collective watching currently and in the future. If time was a thing, which it's not. All right, you guys, you know what? I'm going to give you a quote here. I'm not going to look. It's a book of badassery. Let's give you a little pick-me-up. Why is my collective a badass? For whoever's watching currently and in the future, why is my collective, for whoever's watching, a bad motherfucking ass? Collective, you're a badass because you recognize your wants and your needs. You want it. You want it bad. If you're going to push through major obstacles to reach your goal, you can't just want to. You need to be in a full-on tizzy of excitement about what it is you're going after and hold on to it like a pit bull. In order to do this, you need to have the audacity to be honest about what you really want to do, not what you should do or what other people expect you to do. Believe it's available to you, your true, genuine desires, regardless of any evidence otherwise, and go for it. And that is what makes you a badass, because you can and you will. All right, guys, that's a wonderful energy to start off with, I think. So let's throw 7 cards down of tarot and clarify those motherfuckers. Are you almost done taking a shit over there, Jerry? That'd be great if you could wrap it up, right? Thank you. Okay, yeah, this is my setup right now, guys. It shouldn't really matter, but, you know, I do plan on getting a better setup in the future. I look at other tarot channels and I'm like, it's pretty fancy. They have a fancy microphone and a fancy desk and candles. And here I am on a little desk right next to my cat taking a shit, but it's all good. It's okay. Doesn't matter. Messages matter. All right. So Spirit wants to remind you that you need to be clear about what you want, baby, and not give a fuck about what anybody thinks about it, all right? That message keeps coming up. So do it. Do it. Do it. All right, Spirit, let's give me 6 cards. 7th card. 7th card being the overall energy of the read. All right. I'm just going to flip these over this time, Spirit. Jerry, I see what you're doing. Jerry, you're not even doing it. My cat will scratch post anything. Jerry, that's enough. Excuse me. Okay. As soon as I get up, you get out. Okay, wonderful. No, don't be tempted to go back. You're good. It's covered. It's all taken care of. Okay. All right. I'm just going to lay these out. Thank you, Jerry. That one wanted to come out. See what that one is. We'll look at them at the end here. We got 4. Oh, one came out. Okay. Damn. Okay. Oh, wow. All right. The overall energy of the read. Overall energy of the read, please, for my collective watching currently and in the future. Overall energy of this particular read, Spirit, is the Queen of Wands. Oh, wow. Okay. The Queen of Wands is a very fiery energy, as you could see. Very hopeful, very confident. But there is a tinge of arrogance with the Queen of Wands. Arrogance because this person, male or female, there is no gender in tarot. These are energies. This person has been through it. This person their heart's been broken. They've traveled a long way. They've been through the ringer. And now they've succeeded, so they have this power, but the queen leads with their emotions a lot of the time. Okay, so this person's not thinking about everything through. So that makes things a little bit of a roll of the dice, right? We don't have everything planned out. When you have all this energy and all this passion for something, but you didn't really plan how you're gonna see all of it through. So how does that work? A lot of the times it could be exciting. It could be an adventure. And a lot of times it could totally fail. So you are rolling the dice here. Obviously manifesting here, but not thinking about something fully. So look before you leap. Collective is the message there. We're going to keep that one in mind throughout the whole read, to look before you leap. But the first card that was shown to me, it was the Four of Wands in reverse. Now the Four of Wands usually means that there is some type of a passionate connection that leads to a place of security, comfort, okay, foundation. So that is in reverse. The next one, and the that was turned over, is the Hangman. So needing to step back a little bit, pulling yourself out of the party, taking a deep breath, looking for some enlightenment, thinking about a situation. So that's good. Maybe you're realizing, maybe there's a situation where you're realizing maybe you jumped too soon. Maybe you jumped the gun here. All right, let's get more, guys. So the first one we haven't revealed yet to us is the World card. Holy shit, that is powerful. Holy shit, the World card, the very first card. So you are ending a cycle, collective. There's a something huge going on in your life. You are ending a season in your life and moving on to the next. You have learned, you've leveled up, you've been enlightened, you're done with a chapter, however you want to look at it. This is completion. This is victory. This is victory on a soul level. On a soul level victory. So that's really good. Congratulations on that one, on being your first card. Also, this is number 21. Okay, three. Yeah, I do feel like you're stepping into a whole new world here. And I'm getting that it's a new level of awareness of yourself, of who you are, collective. A new level of awareness of who you are. You're not the same person as you were before. Not that you weren't being authentic, you're just a newer version of yourself, okay? The Emperor in reverse. And that could go a lot of ways. Okay, the Emperor is somebody that handles their business, somebody that takes control, somebody that makes decisions without any question. They know what they are set out to do and they're going to do it. And my God, anybody that's in their way, not a good thing. The next, we have the Ten of Pentacles in reverse. Oh, what's going on here? Ten of Pentacles is riches, celebration of money and family and stability. It's in reverse. What's next? The Ten of Wands in reverse. Ten of Wands is pushing yourself to the limit, doing everything you can. Tired, hungry, pissed off. But doing it, doing the work, but just over it, but not giving up. We have it in reverse here. All right, then we have the Four of Wands and the Hangman. This feels very specific. This feels specific. Okay. So let's see. Let's clarify with the small deck. Regular, lighter weight, miniature deck here. Remember, guys, if you are resonating with the message, if you are enjoying the content, excuse me, in any way, if you'd like to support me, my children in this channel, go ahead and give this video a like, and why not subscribe to my channel? It's all good here. All right, guys, the World card, what's going on? with the World cards here, you have the Four of Pentacles. We have the Judgment in reverse. We have the Page of Swords. We have the Three of Rods in reverse. Let's get one more. Two more? Okay. We have the Five of Cups in reverse and the Queen of Pentacles in reverse. Oh, a lot of pent-up energy here, okay? Meaning people are holding back. Things are being delayed. Someone here has decided to rely on themselves a lot more and not on other people. To save their love, to save their money, to not look at the situation any longer, to fight off communication, to not have any more regrets, and to move forward and away from somebody that is all about money. Someone sees somebody for who they really are, and that is somebody that only cares about money. It could be themselves. It could be you. You could be realizing my priorities have been fucked, and I've been really focusing on my coins, and it's not getting me anywhere. It keeps disappointing me over and over. Okay, somebody might be missing this person, this money. This person with money that highly values money, but is no longer missing them with the Five of Cups in reverse. The Three of Rods in reverse. These are all stock cards. The Page of Swords. Page is a very minute amount of energy, very immature. I think you're doing this. I don't know if you saw my read yesterday, but sneaking away from from a situation here, sneaking away from somebody that focuses too much on money and looks and material things. They don't want to talk about this anymore. This is a non-discussion. Won't even look at it with this Judgment card in reverse. This is another I don't give a fuck card. All right, just looking away, not judging the situation. Maybe not judging them. Definitely not wanting to reconcile, not wanting to go back. This decision has been made. You're no longer giving. To this Queen of Pentacles, no longer giving up your money, no longer giving up your time, your conversation, and you are stepping into a new season without this person because you're seeing their true colors, and maybe you're seeing them in yourself, and you don't like that about yourself, you don't like that about them, and you don't like that you are entertaining the ideas that these are valuable things to you any longer. You're stepping into a whole new perspective here. Well, that's good. All right, so the Emperor in reverse. We talked about the Emperor already. Well, let's see what's going on with the Emperor in reverse. Emperor in reverse can mean somebody that's just a complete jackass, a controlling, manipulative, narcissistic motherfucker. Because the Emperor in upright is someone that has their head on clearly, but someone who definitely is a decision maker. Okay, but an Emperor that is unevolved is someone that is just a controlling douche, right? So let's see. I'm sure that is not you, Collective. None of my viewers are controlling douches. Hell no. Okay, but remember, roles can be reversed. Like you can be the controlling douche. But we're all about change here. I love those too, from afar. All right. Strength in reverse. Uh-oh. Somebody's... okay. So you had control. You had your shit together. You thought you were on the right path. Ooh, I saw it. I can't unsee it. You thought you were on the right path. You're cocky. You thought you had your shit together with this Emperor here, okay? Something went wrong. Something went wrong. Something rubbed you the wrong way, and you turned your concern and your security towards this person. For some reason, you lost your... you needed courage to continue on with this person for some reason. And you're losing that, and your heart is broken. So something happened here. Something happened. You are in pain right now. You are trying to hide it. You are thinking over this situation. I don't think you are willing to go back to this individual, but you are definitely thinking, like, how did I go wrong? How did I let this situation suck me in? Like, it could be literally that they sucked you in. That's a simple answer. But let's see why, what happened here. Oh, yeah. You're leaving this situation. It's chaos. It's crazy. What happened? What did this Queen of Pentacles do with my collective, male or female? What did this motherfucker do to change my baby's attitude? You're all mother this. What did this motherfucker do? Tell us. What happened? What did this person do? What did this person do? Too many cards. Oh, Spirit's got a lot to say. A lot to say. Give me a clear picture. The Knight of Cups in reverse. Oh, shit. This person was out trying to get attention from every fucking buddy. You were, or they were, but I was asking about them. Okay, give us more, give us more. Give us more, please. Give us more. The World card. Oh my gosh, and the Tower card. Holy shit. You got a taste of your own fucking medicine is what happened here. You were falling for somebody. And they betrayed you. They embarrassed you. And they broke your heart. And you're pissed off because they did things to you that you had previously done to other people. And this is why all of this is changing, because you're seeing the light. Wow. This was a fucking tower. This was meant to be. This is karma, guys. Very interesting. Very interesting. All right, let me see. Hold on 1 second, please. All right, so let's clarify the Tower card. What happened here? What happened? Has something to do with this King of Cups. I mean, Knight of Cups. Ooh, the Six of Cups in reverse. Oh, shit. What is going on here, guys? So I think you chose somebody to get over somebody, okay? So you were, what is that term called? When you get with somebody and you're not over your ex. I can't think of the word right now. You were with a, oh God, what is it? Rebound! Rebound, okay? So you were with this rebound, male or female. Doesn't matter the picture. It just tells us that this person appreciated money. They made their own money. They liked yours. They liked attention. They liked getting it. This person doesn't need anything, okay? Real focused on their money. They have it. They do appreciate attention, though. And things. Not the shallowest, not the deepest person in the deck, okay? I'm just saying, no shade on people that follow the money. That's your deal, but I'm just saying this person wasn't too deep, okay? They weren't. Kind of in the middle of something here. No, Jerry. So we got the Six of Cups here. So you were in a rebound with this person, and they were flirting around. I don't know what the fuck they were doing, but they weren't satisfied with your attention, collective. And you were trying to get over somebody. You were putting all your eggs in this basket with this person, and they disappointed you. They disappointed you and got you to see that, you know, it's not cool to be the Knight of Cups. It's not cool to... be a fucking sneaky player ass motherfucker, male or female. It's not fucking cool to mess with people's emotions. It's not cool to lie to them about your intentions, or to, if you didn't do it verbally, it's not good to, it's not okay to insinuate to them or let them go on thinking that a situation is one way when it's really not. Okay, that's stealing. It's stealing time, which is the most valuable fucking thing that you could steal from somebody. Okay, so, I mean, There's other things, but that's one of the biggest. That's life that you can never get back. And that is exactly what the Draco energy, that's how things are crumbled down, wasted time, where you could be putting that time and energy and spirit into something that's lifting things up, that's revealing the truth, right? Instead, hiding things. So yeah, you got what you had given for a lot of times in your life. You felt the pain that other people were feeling that you put upon them. You miss an ex. You missed the person, or you're thinking about the person that you fucked over in the past. And this is clarifying the tower. You were not expecting this, and it's rocked your world. You got the world card twice, motherfucker. This is huge changes. This is a huge fucking character change, upgrade. Okay? You might have went medieval on this person. You turned about face with this person because you saw that they were greedy and hungry and thirsty for, you know, whatever, just looking for attention, just putting too much time on, you know, how things are perceived on the outside, just all that stuff. Okay. And it's made you realize, whoa, this is not what I want. Very interesting, guys. All right. Your next card was 10 of Pentacles in reverse. Let's see what this message is. We discussed that this is a feeling of, this is an energy of, you know, lack, instability, the Hermit card. Nine of Cups. Yes, you are reclusing back, becoming more of a minimalist again. Gotta sneeze. Thank you. Excuse me. To get back to a place where you feel good about being just by yourself again, being alone. You're regrouping here. Getting your happy back. Getting your happy back. Being grateful for what you have in front of you again without needing to. Holy shit. You see what I'm talking about? I'm feeling this energy, guys. It makes you happy to think about the possibility of sharing your life, the happily ever after, with somebody. But I really do think that this Hermit card and this Nine of Cups, that you are working towards that right now. I think this person was a big waste of your time, energy, and money, and an embarrassment, and a kick to the groin. But you learned that lesson. You learned that lesson big time. You might still be in pain, but eventually, you are going to be sitting there broke as fuck, alone, thinking about how you're going to get to a higher frequency, how you're going to get your happy back. Okay, and this is the overall energy of the read. Okay, to not be so confident, not be so ready to jump into someone else's game. Just because they look shiny. Looks aren't everything and can be deceiving. All right, so the Ten of Cups, that's beautiful energy, guys. You are working towards your Ten of Cups. Yeah. Yep. What do we got here? The Three of Cups. Yes, you need a resting period because this bitch, this motherfucker, they really, I mean, you can't hate them because they taught you a lesson. It was purposeful. Your guide sent you them for a purpose. You know, maybe you guys had good sex. I don't think so, though. It was okay. I don't see the devil here. I don't see a whole lot of passion here. Where you bring the passion is when you think about your wish fulfillment. Okay, we did get one card of looking back to someone that you were already very acquainted with. But it could be something new. It could just mean you want that loving feeling back, that you miss that home feeling. It doesn't have to mean a particular ex at all. It could just be, I want that feeling in my life again where I am sharing my life with a partner and they feel like home to me. I miss that. I want to get that back in my life. I want someone in my life that feels like home to me, okay? And that's usually somebody that you've already met, but you never know. Life is strange. But definitely bringing in, letting the flow of love, you know, fill your heart again at some point. Yep, bringing justice to the situation and eliminating the need to be defensive. I do feel you want to get justice, bring justice to the situation. You needed to hit some type of a financial rock bottom, whatever level that is for you. But we have the Justice card here. Let's clarify that. The Death card. Oh, shit. Are you bringing justice to a Scorpio? Hell yes. Justice to Scorpios. Justice to Scorpios. All right, guys. You very well might be wanting to bring justice to a Scorpio. It just might signify that you're putting to death the old you and walking into this new world, this new you, which I think that's what it is, because you're seeing the error of your ways, collective, and you want to do better. You want people to feel better about you when you're around and not have to be so much on their toes. See, that was your thing in the past. And how I know is this Emperor in reverse. But see, you don't understand how to control energy. You don't understand the responsibilities of power. You understand that you have all these things, but you are not understanding how and not really knowing yourself good enough to direct these things in a positive way. So, you know, in the past, you really have been using your power and your energy like this, okay? You know that you have it, but you're not really emotionally together to use it for the good. Use it properly and most effectively, okay? All right, so let's get to the Ten of Wands. Nine of Rods here is the last card, clarifying the Ten of Pentacles. And what comes next is the Ten of Wands. All right, so the Ten of Wands in reverse, letting go of this. I feel like this is letting go of the mask that you've been putting on, okay? I just feel like with this card, this particular deck, you're running away from something here for a very long time. And you're like, have I walked far enough from this bullshit? Or am I almost there to where I'm supposed to be? It's been a long fucking journey, man. And you're ready to put down that bag. You're ready to tie up your bowl, tie up the bullshit, put down your bags and smoke a bowl and just fucking relax. You're putting down the burdens, man. You don't want to think about something anymore. What is it? What is it? I do feel like you're just holding up the star in reverse. Yes. There's this persona about yourself that you've been holding on to for a very long time. You know, I'm okay. I'm awesome. I have a lot of confidence. I'm good. I'm okay. But the star in reverse, I feel like you're letting that go. You're letting the need to look strong when it's not authentic. You're letting it go. I think you're starting to open up. Eight of Cups in reverse. This does mean reconciliation. This does mean turning back from a situation that you walked away from that didn't work out the first time around, that you gave up on. This is turning back. Let's see what else we got. Whoa, shit. Look at that. And I wasn't going to take it if it fell on the floor. It's the Queen of Swords in reverse. This is somebody that told you off, that told you to go fuck yourself. This is a breakup. Oh, shit, you guys. Here we are again. Give me more on this Queen of Swords. The Page of Raj. Holla. You want to holla? You want to holla? You want to say, hey, 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 how you doing? How you doing? How you doing? Hey, 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 hey. How you doing? How's it going? I did not call you on my table. So, yeah, you want to holla back. Holla back. How you doing? Think about you all the day, all the night. And I want you. Get out of here. Jerry, come on. You already know. All right. So you want to contact this person? Let's move on to the Four of Wands in reverse. What's going on? What's going on with this? Fucking stubborn ass. A Four of Cups. Collective, this is telling me that you do not want to commit. You do not want to put a foundation down anywhere because you are not capable of being satisfied by any person. And this is your problem right now, collective. Whoever I'm talking to, This might not be your fucking read. It's not your read. It's not your read. I'm reading for the whoever's in my energy. All right. So if it's not your time around, then it's someone else. All right. If you're here still, then this is obviously a read, or you just miss me. The Two of Rods, you see. And this is why you're in the hangman mode, because you don't know what to do. Nobody compares to this person you're thinking about, but you don't want to commit to them. And you know that they want commitment. You're thinking about it. You want to holler back. You just want to holler. See, you got the page here. Page is a very low commitment. This is a child. You don't want to make any commitments here. You're back to square one. You are feeling like you are raising up here in your womanhood, in your manhood, with this karmic over here that was all about money. But then they shattered your fucking, your big mask. Smashed that into pieces. You got humbled here. You want your ex back. You miss them, but you don't want to commit. You're going to do the same fucking cycle. Then what? You're going to decide that you're so lonely, you're going to go back to another karmic? Something's got to give here. Okay? This is boring. Knight of Pentacles in reverse. Not a card. Jerry! Get out! Jerry! What is your deal, dude? Chill. I had to cut those balls off ASAP. Damn. Five of Pentacles sneaked out. This person that you miss, that you don't want to commit to, but you do want to fuck, that you miss and doesn't compare to anybody, that you're thinking about, is constantly making you feel left out on the cold because they know your deal. They don't want this Knight of Pentacles energy or this Knight of Cups energy either. They don't want in and out energy. They don't want it, just like you don't want it. You can't expect people to focus on you when you're focusing on everybody else. You want your cake and eat it too, and so you're left out in the cold. You're not going to get it. You have to. Oh my God. How annoying. Seven of Rods. Yeah, you're... I have the feeling I'm not the only person that's been telling you this shit. But you're fighting. You're standing. You're fighting to keep this type of mentality, that it's possible for you to be happy being in a limbo state. The Lovers in reverse. What kind of a decision is that? The Lovers in reverse. The Two of Pentacles. Oh shit, you've made some kind of a decision now. What is it? Ending with the Hangman, though. Oh, that wasn't for us. This one slid in my hand, though. The King of Cups in reverse. Oh, fuck. Wow. You've decided that you're not going to be anybody's caregiver. Fuck, man. What the fuck? Two of Swords. You don't want to look at... What do they not want to look at? Face Collective. What are they avoiding? What are they avoiding, please? What is going on with this person here? King of Pentacles in reverse and the Eight of Pentacles in reverse. You are a lone wolf in your head. You don't want anything from anybody. You don't want to give anything to anybody. You want to make it very clear that you don't have a lot to offer and that you don't want to take a lot either. What you do have is ego. What you do have is stubbornness. What you do have is a tenacity to hold the position of, you know, you're saying, I know who I am and that's it. But with these two world cards, I think you're just scared. You don't know any way else to live because you've been so disappointed in the past that this is just a defense mechanism. You really do want to be emotionally connected. You have just been in so much pain. Everyone that you've ever loved has betrayed you or left you, period. Everyone that you've ever got close to has left you or has hurt you. Okay? I'm so sorry about that. But this is no way to live. You can't go on like this. The four of rods, and it almost fell to the ground, and I caught it. You want this, but you're so scared that it's going to fuck up. You want to live happily ever. You want to celebrate your stability with somebody. You want 10 of cups. And I want to beat my cat's ass. What's your problem? I'm sorry. I don't know what's going on with my cat's possessed today. Hey, what's going on? It's walking around like a freaking puma right now. Damn. All right, four of wands. Give me more. The Empress in reverse. You're missing this Empress. We got the Emperor in reverse in the beginning. The Emperor is missing his Empress. See, you are looking for someone that you could respect on an equal level. But your ego is getting you in the way of seeing people's worth. I do feel like a lot of people have crossed your path that you didn't see was worthy of your time, your effort, and you treated them like shit because you thought you were better than them. And you went for the things that were shiny and popular, and they really ended up being shit. You don't have to lie to kick it, collective, okay? It's actually time to start getting real now, okay? If this is not a fucking sign for you, I don't know what to tell you, man. You're still in this hangman mode, okay? This is the last card for you. Remember, the overall energy is don't fucking leap too soon, Froggy. The Queen of Rods. This is the Queen of Wands and the Magician in reverse. What did I fucking tell you? Yes, you're powerful. Yes, your energy, you can manipulate. But be the student. Learn about what the fuck you're actually doing when you're doing it. Think about things before you fucking do it. That's where your ego and your cockiness comes in. You move recklessly. You live day by day. You don't give a fuck what's going to happen. So you don't give a fuck about the consequences here. And that's very selfish. And this is what you're learning here. I do feel like this karmic gave you an opportunity to learn that these ways are not okay. You're really thinking about it. You're in hermit mode, trying to get that fucking love back in your heart. You know, because it's in there. Your authentic, beautiful, male or female, handsome self is in there, okay? It's very much so buried. It's very much so buried. You know, you could have had some childhood trauma here. There's some pages coming out here. But you definitely want to reach out to an ex because you know that they're still hurting from this. And that makes you hurt too. And you want to end their hurt. You realize that you did them dirty, seeing your part in it, you know. Let's get a couple more cards here underneath the Ten of Swords in reverse. Lots of ten. See, Nine of Swords in the upright and the Eight of Rods in reverse. Wow, guys. You want to take away, you want to heal them. You want to take away their pain. Look at this is a lighter card, okay? I do feel like this person, like you've met your counterpart already. I do feel like you want to get more intimate with this person, open up more, be your true authentic self, open up your heart to this person more, tell them how you feel more. You want to take away their pain, straight up. Nine of Swords, Eight of Rods in reverse. You want to take their pain away, period. That's what you want to do. Let's get three cards from the Hidden Truth Oracle, and then that'll close out the read. Thank you for joining me here at Hard Knocks Tarot. Remember, if any of this content affected you in any way, please like and subscribe. And if you think this is going to help somebody that you know, go ahead and share it as well. Three cards. Three closing out cards for my collective, please. Three cards for my collective, please. From the collective, we have I know I messed everything up. This could be you or your person. I hide behind material things. Yeah, and one more. Not for us. Get off the birdcage, Jerry.
Good thing this is almost over. My bird's in danger now. Mm-mm. Never a dull moment up in here. And another turned over, and it is, I feel you leaving me behind. The next one is, I am afraid to contact you. That has been your read, my lovelies. Thanks for joining me once again. I love you. Come on back. I'll see you soon. Merry Christmas and namaste.